Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play Paper Mario. I was actually just clearing out some enemies so we didn't have to fight any at the beginning of the episode, and what do you know? We got a level up here. So we're just gonna go with badge points. I forget what I said I was gonna get, but we're just gonna get badge points. So anyways, in the episode before the last episode, Yoshi Kids went missing, all that nonsense. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna look around. We can't do anything with that raven statue at the moment, but we're gonna go down here, down as in self, because that makes sense. It does make sense when you think about it. He cries for half a second, and looks like we woke him up. He's bluish purple. It's hard to tell on this TV. Maybe he's both. Maybe he's neither. But anyways, if you go over here, you can actually make a shortcut, which is pretty sweet. And, wait a second. He went this way. Where did he go, even? I don't know. That's kind of weird. But, this is a shortcut back to the village. We just got a level up, so we don't need a heal or anything. So we're just gonna continue along and all that, and ignore that guy, because I don't feel like fighting any enemies, and we're at a pretty good level, so it's not like we need to. There is a single coin, and I will grab it. Yeah, I guess we can just move along. Yeah, we'll do something with that statue later. But for now, ah, great. Can you give me... Alright. Let's prepare for this. Cooper, maybe. For some reason, when I was a kid, this was, or at least it seemed so much harder than it probably really is. What should we use? There's quite a few things we can use. I would probably just recommend something that's good for attack, like Power Smash or... Sure, no, we don't really need that. We're probably gonna just use... Whatchamacallit, Happy Flower... Do we have Happy Flower? Oh, it's 3! Duh. Okay, never mind me. We got 2 deep focus for some reason. Look at me just fumbling through this. Yeah, we'll go with that. Even though when you're in danger, you really should be healing, but whatever. Anyways, I picked Cooper, so he can use that shell thing that attacks multiple enemies. Anyways, there's just 2 of them, but I remember them being fairly difficult. So if we get into trouble, we got some stone caps, which I got for the anti-guy fight, but never actually used, and I believe jumping still does a bit... I believe it does a little bit more damage than using your hammer, so that's what we're doing. Great. Yeah, we got poison. Well, at least when you're poisoned, you can't get double poisoned. Of course, I dodged it that time. Alright. Yeah, because jumping is like 2 things you do, and this isn't as hard as I remember, is it? This is gonna be easy. But yeah, it's a mini-boss thing. And obviously, the stats are for them individually, not for both of them combined. Cause, why would I do that? Just to clarify. Alright, we got ourselves star points. And we rescued, I think, the last Yoshi kid. Who is almost as tall as Mario, actually. Which is kind of funny. Luigi is a bit taller than Mario, but I'm sure you guys all knew that. I'm just saying, in this game, he is. In the older game, he's not. Yeah, we got that, whatchamacallit, victory thing. Victory screech! Okay, we're not gonna do that, even though I just did. But, I suppose now we are done. We are done indeed. So, let's just remember where that statue is. We won't have to remember too much about it since we have made ourselves a shortcut here. Very nice. Back to the Yoshi Village. And panic music is gone. By the way, I got some of this stuff from the item shop here, so yeah. And you were here before, so for a second I was just like, wait, are you new here? Maybe? I don't know, just me getting a little confused. And so the Chief Yoshi, the fat guy, is over here. And so what do we get for saving all the Yoshi kids? He takes us over here. And, yeah, no comments. And we get the Jade Raven. Okay. Seemingly useless, but in fact quite useful, because we actually need it to progress. Alright, so he talks a lot. I don't usually like reading it out loud, because I usually mess up really bad, and it doesn't make for very good professional commentary-ish type things, and there's a lot of dialogue, and once again, this Let's Play would be at least twice as long if I actually read, like, everything. I remember when I started this, I started doing weird, like, voice acting things, but, it's not a good idea. Voice acting is a bad idea for me during Let's Plays. Professionally, voice acting, sure. I'll do that. Why not? But, during Let's Plays, it doesn't work out because it's improvised-ish. You know, like, probably what happened with, like, the Charlie's Angels video game. Probably everything was just, like, them reading their lines for the first time. Yeah, I don't know how you could possibly like that game. You can't, there's not even an end to the game. Like, the game just, like, infinitely repeats. It might as well just not even work. Oh, wrong way. We're going this way. Don't get lost now. Don't you get lost. So, yeah, now we can go over to the Raven statue. So, yeah, it's pretty obvious. Very young me figured this out quite easily. 8-year-old me, maybe? Is that how old I was? I don't remember. It was 13 years ago when this came out. I don't know, who cares. Anyways, so this is a new jungle area thing. With the vines that you can grab onto. Get an egg. We're just gonna run past you, because I feel like it. Yeah, I know I'm avoiding a lot of enemies, but I'd rather fight them off screen unless they're, like, brand new enemies or something. Then I'd like to, show them off at least once for you guys. This is more or less a walkthrough type Let's Play with, you know, semi-professional commentary. You don't want it to be fully professional, because then it's boring. You don't want to watch that. Unless you just want to walk through. But some people may. Maybe you don't like Chugga Conroy, and that's why you're watching me. I think he's cool, but I don't know. Maybe just me. Anyways, yeah, it's a... I mean, is that even a puzzle? Because I don't know if you could even consider that a puzzle. It's just plug the holes. And I messed up. Good job, me. Well, I just messed up the simplest, not even puzzle in the game. Wow, did I really mess it up that bad? Okay, let's just take this one. Alright. This really should not even take more than, like, 2 seconds. Oh, man. I messed up. That reminds me of Proton John's stream last night. And all I can say is... disappointed! Which is my favorite new meme. Of all... just my favorite new meme right now. It's great, and I should have attacked the one back, but whatever. Alright. So, we've used sushi before, right? I'm pretty sure we have. But, pretty much the same action command as, Cooper, so... not much of a problem. We also got the, squirt ability, which will be useful later on. But, it's not too useful right now. Alright, what was I doing? Let's grab this. Oh, sweet. And I just bought one of these too. Stupid me. Anything I can use? No? Nothing? Oh, wait. Sleepy Sheep is useless. Useless item is useless. Man, I gotta stop checking all these trees. What am I even doing? All you need to do is check this one to open up the path. That's all you really need. And, time to butt stomp everywhere. I call it butt stomp. Cause I'm... oh, come on now! Really? Like, it's... there's one pixel between Mario's belly and that oh. I thought it was gonna be, like, all cutscene-y. Oh, this is the fight I remember. Yeah, this is gonna be a pain. Oh, and I didn't change part of good job, me. Good job. Anyways, once again, Cooper, probably one of the best party members. Because he can do this. And after you upgrade him even more, he can do even more than that. And I missed that action command because it's a pretty stupid action command when you think about it. Oh, you son of a... butter squatch. Squatch? I meant squat. Squat. I can't even say it right now. Blech. My mouth is wrong. Something. Alright. Time to kick butt. And all that stuff. Alright. Yeah, I didn't really expect any of them to be dead. But I was hoping. I know that was only 6 damage, but I don't know how much the guy at the end is. Yeah, just keep on doing that now. Nobody finds that annoying. Jump cut, even though we're on the same screen. Anyways, I think we should just use Thunder Rage. I'm pretty sure they sell it at the store nearby, so not a huge problem. Oh, they're still alive. You fools! And this should take care of all of them at once. Or not. Nope. Mm-hmm. More poison. Thank you, sir. May I have another? Whatever. Nobody gets your references. Yeah, but now they should be dead. Right? Yeah, they go spinning around. More references no one gets. Alright. And the last guy. I'm just gonna use the hammer. Because of why not. Yeah, see, that does 5, and if you do the jump right, it does 6. And I pretty much always get the jump right, so... aww, coins that we'll probably not need. Alright, where were we? Right, we're going this way. To the Boggly Woods tree, or not. That's another game, silly. Anyways, that's blocked off, I believe. Anyways, if you go over here, or, oh, is it not over here? I swear there was something over there. Huh. That's weird. What if we do this? And there's no, symbol thing above Mario's head, so guess nothing. Anyways, this reminds me of Super Paper Mario, this part, where you climb inside the tree. Lots of platforming and whatnot. So we're just gonna go up here. I don't think can you? No, you can't even fall off. So if you continuously go up, you get Happy Heart, which we spent money / star pieces on, but whatever. And this is here, and I don't even know why. Weird design stuff. I wish Mario games had better design. Instead, they're all, like, boring. Like, I miss this stuff, where they just, like, put random crap places whenever they feel like it. Anyways, you go over here and giant raven. So raven. So anyways, you talk to this, giant raven guy. And so, he's all like, hey, I'll help you get to, the volcano. And he calls his normal-sized ravens. They don't even really look like ravens, but oh well. They all have little feets. Look at their little feets. I don't know if you can see their little feets, but I can. And their little feets. That's title of the episode. I only make titles of the episode when I feel like it. And I decide this shall be called Little Feets. And if I, don't do that, then remind me, or something. We're just gonna follow him. Weeeeee you. Alright. What is up? Big Feets? For some reason, I find that funny. Also, his big feets disappear. We're gonna stop talking about that starting now. Alright. Yeah, I guess there is nothing back there. Huh. Strange indeed. And there was a hidden path there the whole time. Look at all the ravens. Nevermore. Yeah, even more people won't get that. Unless they're like, that was from The Simpsons, right? It's just like when someone's like, I love those Zelda games, but I wonder what the princess's name is. Anybody else see that caption picture? No, just me. So, anyways, they're building stuff, apparently. Or maybe they're just punching the tree, who knows. Nope, they're building stuff. Well, I did know they were building stuff. I didn't want to spoil it, so I put doubt into your mind for half a second to brainwash you. So, yeah, this will help us get across the lava river-ish type thing. So, we got the Ultra Stone. This will let us upgrade our party members even more. Which is pretty sweet. We're gonna want that. But that's actually gonna do it for this episode. So, next time on Let's Play Paper Mario, we're gonna go and grab an upgrade block, because there's actually one we can get to right now. Then we're gonna continue on into the volcano. So, thanks for watching. If you like my video, do the things that the YouTube people tell you to do, and I'll see you next time.